गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल. माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर सुष्मिता शुक्ला, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एट सेंटर फॉर प्लांट एंड एनवायरमेंट बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, अमिटी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, अमिटी यूनिवर्सिटी, विल बी गोइंग टू स्पीक ऑन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ प्लांट टिश्यू कल्चर फॉर बायोडाइवर्सिटी एंड कंजर्वेशन ऑन दिस ऑस्पिशियस ओकेजन ऑफ द सेलिब्रेशन विच वी आर डूइंग ऑफ वर्ल्ड एनवायरमेंट डे 2021 विद WWF एंड दिस RP. With starting note, I would like to show this, I would like to go with this cartoon picture where all the, right from the childhood onwards, we have started talking about the biodiversity and conservation. Here is a discussion shown between two students, two guys who are talking about the importance of the ecosystem and the biological treasure which the India is so rich with. So it is the important measures which has been taken to protect our biodiversity, and this is how the CBT came into act and under which we are having a specific target to meet with. So keeping this thing, various concept map was made related to the threats to the biodiversity which is going on, the causes of biodiversity extinction and the disturbance which is being happening, pattern of diversity, everything has been mapped. And where various people, various scientists are working in the different areas. The specific area which I am dealing with is the plant diversity and conservation in India and the others. So specifically, we are going for the micropropagation protocol, where we are dealing with all the different protocols which is required. Specifically, we are selecting some of the important species, plant species, which are in extinction phase or which are in endangered categories or red listed plants. So here the broad area of my research is micropropagation, as I've already told, and why micropropagation, as it is having a huge, huge applications and advantages with respect to the mass multiplication. Other thing is that the embryo rescue and the phytochemical screening, which we can go for, we can identify the different medicinal properties and the chemical constituents which are present in the plant, specific the phytochemical constituents, we can say, and we can extract that, and we can, without harming or without sacrificing the plants, we can have those things in a lab. So here some of the plant species I am just giving and highlighting the name of this, which is having an important place in the biodiversity and the conservation part. Stereospermum personatum, Stereospermum sabulans, Punica granatum, Olea europaea, Musa, indigenous Musa variety, and citrus are some of the plant species, and basically mainly the tree species which I have worked on. Stereospermum personatum and sabulans, when we talk about, these are the one of the important tree species which is having a very important impact, not only related, only related to the timber wood quality, but it is having a huge potential of the Ayurvedic formulation, which people has been taken and are being still using. As you might have heard about the Dasmalarist and the Chyawanprash, which nowadays people are very much oriented to, and they are having as to increase their immunity. So as an immunity booster also it is being used. So these plants are being, has been put in the category, are in the extinction phase, has been reported by many of the scientists, which we can get. And why this was happening? Because of the over-exploitation of the roots, because all the maximum, the nutrient content, the medicinal contents are present in the roots, and from the roots only these Ayurvedic formulations, etc., has been prepared. So there was an emergent need so that we can increase these plant species, as the germination rate is also below 20%. So we need to increase that particular percentage as well. Another important variety which I have worked on is the Citrus macropyrrha, which is again an endangered category, put in the endangered category, and we are the one who has successfully developed the protocol, and now we can say that yes, 100% we can protect this thing, this plant species, and we can conserve this. So soon we will be coming with the publication of this important tree species which we have developed. Now the thing is that we need to go for large scale production and for the conservation purpose, as there are different forest area or some of the other thing which is already available, we can go and we can protect those things. So why this came into existence, why we went for this kind of thing, as we know that plant biodiversity is declining due to various varied factors. For example, you can say the physical or the environmental factors or the man-made factors also, you can say. So biodiversity conservation is a global concern which we have to understand, and by varied means we have to protect our biodiversity, our own germplasm. And specifically when we go for the agriculture forest biodiversity, we know that there is a huge potential and we need to respect and we need to protect this biodiversity. As again, I would say that during this COVID situation and the pandemic situation, these are the things without which we cannot live. These are the things where the agriculture is surviving. We are not having any lacuna, you can say, or we are not lacking behind with respect to food and getting all the things on time. So we have to understand the importance of this, and therefore the plant biotechnology, I can say that 100% yes, we are plant biotechnologies are doing a very good job with respect to the conservation and micropropagation, or whatever is required. If we are knowing this particular technology, we can produce the plant product anytime, anywhere, within a small period of time, within a small area. So this is what our work or our expertise belong, where we not only go for producing the protocols, but we do multiply in large scale. And after that, we can go for the germplasm conservation, which we can store in the gene banks, which is already there. Just a glimpse of micropropagation I would like to show you to make you understand that how micropropagation works. So it is a technique through which stock or the mother plants are rapidly multiplied to produce the clonal progenies using this particular technique. So when we talk about stalk, that is the explant, that is a small piece of plant which has been taken from a mother plant. And the explant can be anything, as it is very rich in the potential. It is having, all the explants are having high rich potential, where the things are there, seeds, nodes, and nodal segment, and leaves, everything can be taken. Right. For example, in the seed, when we are taking the seed, the node and the leaf section, we can produce the plants in a very, very rich condition. For example, in vitro regenerated plants are there, where we can go for shoot proliferation. After that, we can go for the multiple shoot proliferation. Then we can go for the rooting purpose. After rooting, we can go for the hardening, and finally we will be getting the field oriented plant, that is the field acclimatized plant. The other area is the through callus production, that is the indirect organogenesis, where we can go for the callus production. From callus, we can go for the multiple shoot proliferation. From shoot proliferation, again we can go, we'll be moving with the rooting area, and thereafter again we'll be getting the hardened plant, which is ready to go into the field, and it will be definitely acclimatized there, as we have already made those plants hardened to acclimatize in that particular natural condition. Here is the process of plant tissue culture, where you can see the overall scenario which I have described in my previous slide, where the parent plant is there, selection of explant, we are doing it, it is being cut, it is being inoculated in the different media, it is put in a specific aseptic condition where it is there. Then you can see if it is an indirect organogenesis, you can get the callus in your hand, from where you can go for the shoot proliferation, transferring to the rooting, and thereafter in the hardening for the acclimatization stage. So this is the overall process of plant tissue culture. And here another important parameter of this plant tissue culture, you can see the artificial seed production. If you have produced such kind of thing which is of endangered category or of some important economically importance it is having, and you want to store it, keep it in a gene bank, and you don't want to grow right now, so the gene banks are available where you can encapsulate your the propagules there, whatever explant is there, whatever cultures you have produced, cryopreserve it and just keep it in the gene bank, and whenever there is a requirement you can get it and you can produce it. So this is the small lab which I do have in Amity campus. We are working on such kind of things. And these are the culture room, and my PhD scholars who are enjoying their work, they are working there. And coming to the conclusion part, this is an important seminar of the organization which is being done for creating awareness about the environment biodiversity conservation. And I can definitely say that plant biotech is having a very important specialty, where we can do a lot of things related to the germplasm conservation, whether it is an endangered species, whether it is a rare, where this is extinction phase, or any of the plant species which we want to go for mass multiplication. we can do for. So yes, to produce, to protect our environment, we need to grow plants, not only through the natural cultivation method, but the biotechnology, the applied plant biotechnology come much into the role, and we have to understand the importance of it, and we can go for the production or the germplasm conservation. With this, I would like to thank everybody, especially the Honorable Founder President, Sir Dr. Ashok K. Chauhan, Amity University, Honorable Chancellor, Sir Dr. Atul Chauhan, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Ma'am Dr. Balwinder Shukla, Director, Amity Institute of Biotechnology, and specifically Mr. Kumar Ranjan, who is the Program Officer of this Remote Sensing and GIS of WWF NVSRAP, who has given me opportunity to talk in this important platform. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.